Hey, what's up guys, I'm Aditya from fastprice.com. So Samsung recently released its flagship S10 series, the regular Galaxy S10, the S10 Plus and the S10e models. But there is another thing that Samsung has done that I guess needs equal attention, and that's the software, the One UI. Because after failing for like two times, first with the TouchWiz, then with the Samsung Experience, the company is again in the market with their third skin, that's the One UI running on top of Android Pie. And it's quite compelling. So it's obvious that comparisons will be made with the stock Android. So that's what I'm going to do in this video. So the main selling point of One UI is that it's trying to fix one big problem with your smartphone, and it's the smartphone itself. I mean, all the phones are getting bigger and bigger these days, and it's so problematic that my teammate has even made a separate video on that topic. So what you get on One UI is the new interface where everything has moved towards the bottom of the screen. And so it's a lot easier for people with small hands to use their gigantic phones with just one hand. For example, like in the notifications bar, I can easily tap on most of the quick action buttons, although it's still very hard for me to reach the Wi-Fi and sound buttons. So maybe I can put these options in some place where my fingers can easily reach. And also this Note 9 is quite big, and my experience would have been better if I had used the One UI on a smaller phone. Still, in this case, One UI is somewhat better than the stock Android Pie, where you can easily open the app switcher and the app drawer, but there aren't many quick action buttons that you can tap while using your phone with just one hand. Also, one big problem on all the big phones is pulling down the notification bar itself, and I mean, you just can't do that. Yes, you can use third-party apps and you can configure the fingerprint sensor to do the same, but I think that's just a workaround and not the actual solution, because what if your phone does not have a sensor at the back at all, like on this S10 Plus? So Samsung has a fix for the problem, and you can enable this swipe gesture to pull down your notification bar, although here also it only works on the home screen. Still, something is better than nothing. Also, in the case of the stock Android Pie, you can enable the accessibility menu in the settings app, and then you can easily open the quick actions button or the notifications panel. But again, as I said, it is also just a workaround. Anyway, you can see Samsung's new design in almost every part of the new software. And what Samsung has done is that it has divided the screen into two parts, the viewing area where you will see all the content and the interaction area where the company puts all of the controls. Like here is the settings app. You can see that the names of the features are all blown up and all the tappable part has been moved down. You can go to any of the submenu options and same thing happens there also. Also, Samsung has redesigned many of its system apps, so all of the important options are now well within the reach of your fingers, like in the clock app and the My Files app, the contacts and so on. Thankfully, the company has even fixed the crappy camera app and now it feels much better to use. So if you compare this thing with stock Android Pie and Google apps, I think that there is a scope for improvement, although in some apps, a bunch of options are easily reachable already. And here also, it's a good thing that Google has already moved the search bar to the bottom. Still, you'll realize that things aren't that easy, mostly because of the size of the phone. So here, I guess One UI should get a plus point for the ergonomics. And seriously, maybe like for the first time, I'm kind of surprised that I'm liking the software that Samsung is putting in its phones. It's making the phone so much usable, it has leveled up the smoothness, and it looks eye-popping on the AMOLED displays on these Galaxy phones. Also on the S10 Plus, it fits very well with this pill-shaped display cutout. So I don't think that it's going to be as annoying as the notch on other phones. Still, in any case, it's just the beginning and Samsung needs to work more on their software. Anyway, One UI isn't just about moving everything to the bottom. Samsung has also tried its gestures, and it turns out that every other gesture navigation is somehow better than the stock Android. Because in some way, the gestures on Android Pie actually defeat the whole point of gesture navigation. I mean, you are not getting that extra space on your screen for which it's there in the first place. Now, One UI's gestures might not be the best, but still you are getting that extra space on your screen, and also you can tweak the gestures according to your needs. Now, one of the things that I want from almost every app and operating system that I use is the dark mode. So on Samsung's One UI, it is called the night mode, and it's absolutely not anything like the fake dark mode that we see on the stock Android Pie, in which half of the UI is still white even when you enable the dark mode. But on the One UI, the dark mode is dark system-wide, and actually it's a black mode, and that's because of the OLED displays on the Samsung flagships. Your phone can turn off individual pixels that are not fueling any UI element or any feature, and so you get this pitch black screen on your device that you are not getting on stock Android Pie. This thing saves more battery and it looks more visually appealing, but I don't think that it's that big of a deal breaker. And by the way, Android 10's first preview build is already out and it has finally got the system-wide dark mode that we have always wanted. So yes, Google has got us covered for 2019 and late Android versions. Now, if you want to know more about the latest Android features, then you can watch our video using the link above. Apart from these, there are many other features such as the new floating keyboard that's already there on Android Pie, then the recycle bin in the gallery app, again, which is also there on Google Photos app, the secure folder and more. Also, this time Samsung has tried to cut down on the bloatware and you can remove many Samsung apps from your phone, although Facebook and some Microsoft apps will still take up the space. On the other hand, there are no third-party apps on stock Android Pie, but Google's own apps are like bloatware these days because you just can't remove most of them. Now, it's hard to pick a winner in this case, actually not that hard, but still I can't just declare that one is better than the other because both One UI and the stock Android Pie have their own list of pros and cons. But one thing I'd like to say is that One UI has lived up to my expectations and thumbs up to Samsung for making their gigantic phones more usable. And surely I'd like to give One UI a more long-term use, maybe like half a year or so, but I'm still skeptical whether the company will push timely updates because it took them like 4 months to release Android Pie even on their flagship devices. Anyway, that's my opinion and you can tell me yours in the comments down below. So what do you think about One UI? As always, if you like this video, then you can give me a thumbs up. If you loved it, then subscribe, hit the bell icon, make sure that you share this video with your friends and family, and I'll talk to you in the next one.